Hello my friends, welcome to this video in which I will be talking about spotlights. So of course a professional shop would be spending hours in explaining the different models. Here I will make it very simple, going only to the essentials. I wanted to thank here the shop B&S Mat. This shop is a very important contributor to my channel because it's there where I'm finding many material but also many solutions. So many thanks to Maurice for his help. They were so kind of putting at my disposal today the different spots I'll be showing you. I would say the range is extremely wide, so it starts from very cheap ones which are around 10 euros and then you have the hermetic ones that are a bit more expensive. And the range goes up to hundreds of euros for very high-level spotlights. Spotlights are a very interesting source of lighting because they are now with LED technologies consuming very few electricity, and they are also giving a very clear light, which you can also see in the series of videos about the organization of a kitchen. So the first thing you can notice is there are some models which enable a slight orientation of the spotlight. You see here, these are the previous spots I had, and there's an inclination possibility at 180 degrees. This is the same for this one, which is not for red rooms. And then you have other ones which you cannot change the inclination, like this model here, which is for red rooms. There's also this type, this is a special flat one with a reservation that in case the bulb is broken, you have to change the whole lamp. Sometimes you have some space constraints on the top. For instance, this one here is 6.5. This one here, special flat one. So here it's around, let's say 4.5, but there's a big space needed here on the top, whereas the old ones, low tension, they're around, let's say 5, but the space required on the top is smaller. Also to be noticed, for the spotlights with our four normal rooms, meaning not wet rooms, there is nothing special written on it, whereas the spotlights for wet rooms are with this standard IP65. In case you need to change the whole spotlight, just be aware that there are these feathers on the back, which enable a good positioning of the spotlight into the ceiling. Pull firmly on the spotlight and it will then go out. On the previous models, it was a bit more elaborated. These clamps enabled a good positioning of the spotlight into the ceiling, but the principle is the same. So just pull on the spotlight for changing it totally. Now, a very important information about the bulbs. You see here, this model has these two needles on the top for inserting into the socket. You just push them inside like this, but be careful, this type of socket is for low tension, which means that you will have to use a transfer. And on the video that I made, I could see that there was one transfer used for two bulbs. On the other hand, you have these type of bulbs with this superior part, which is bigger. For inserting them, you just put it like this. Then you turn. Here, this is another model which was provided with with the normal spotlights, not for dry room. So quite important, you have here different types of bulbs. You see here, this here is saying warm, which means that it will provide a yellowish light. And you see here, this is cool. This means that it will be a very cold white light, which in the end is good to have in kitchens and bathrooms, for instance. So this here is a simple one, not for eight rooms. And if you want to change the bulb, remove this little ring here, and then you can remove the bulb. On this more ancient model, it's the same approach, but it's looking differently. So here it's the same, you take out the ring. Just remove this ring and this will release the bulb. For putting it back the other way around. So for this ancient model, you can use the elongated plier. You've already seen my video about the basic toolbox. And it's very easy to do thanks to the plier. For eight rooms, you will see that there is this cover here. So you don't have directly access to the to this here. But it's the same principle. Once you have removed the cover, then you just open like this and your bulb is free. For connecting the spots to the circuit, so I'm starting here with a low tension. Here you will connect the two wires directly into the transfo. You see here the exit voltage, which is 11.5, low voltage. You can also use an extension wire for being able to reach the transfo where it is in the ceiling. Second option is the normal tension bulbs. So here you will directly put them into a connector, which will then be hidden into the ceiling. And here, this is another model which had been provided within the box. And here you just open. Connections are made here. For connecting lightning, I warmly recommend this type of connector. This is a clipsable Waco. You insert the wire here and then you clip it down. And this will be very interesting because we have different sections of wires, and this is much easier to manage with this type of connector. Otherwise, you can also use the dominoes. One little notice, in case you need to connect only one wire of arrival of electricity, then you can use the small ones. But in case you have, for instance, the electricity arriving on this side, but you need to connect two wires on the back for reaching two different spots, then it will be better to take the bigger size of these dominoes. To have separated dominoes. So it's the same, I'm putting together the socket for the first spot, the arrival of electricity, and the bridge to the other spot. buying the spotlights, you should be knowing upfront if you want to have low voltage or normal voltage. Here in this box, the default socket provided was for low tension. So in this case, don't forget to buy the normal tension socket in addition. And in this type of box, we have these connectors provided. So these you can recognize here, they are with normal tension. You see here that these here are already pre-stripped. Just remove the pre-strip and then you can put them directly into the connector. Also to be noticed that the boxes have either the bulbs already inside, this is the case of this pack, and not this one, for which you will need to buy an additional bulb. So either for the normal tension or with the low tension. That's it, my friends. Now you know everything about spotlights. And for making your journey more pleasant, I'm now very pleased to invite you to a video in which I am showing you concretely how I'm changing the spotlights in my bathroom. This here is a humid room, so I will use this type. But of course, who can do the more can do the less. So it applies to any type of spotlights. So see you in a second on Happy Hour TV 1.